Using the book search tools, we're starting at Google's homepage. We're starting with the word peace for this demonstration. At the top of the page, you'll notice that there's all results, images, news, videos, and books. Usually books are out as a choice. If not, look under more and use, and it will be listed here. We're clicking on books. Then you notice at the top of the books page, all of the results are now books, A, and there are a bunch of tools here that allow you to limit and sort your results so that you can narrow it down. The first menu is any books. Your choices is everything, any books. Preview available. Preview available shows you books that have a preview, which means they can be looked at. Generally, the book that you're going to be looking at, it will load the places where you can find the keywords. So that's the purpose of that. The next choice is to get. Google eBooks. Google eBooks are books you can buy right here from Google and Google Peace. Some of them are reasonable, some of them are unreasonable, but they're all digital editions of these books, which makes it really helpful if you need an eBook. And then the last choice are free Google eBooks. These are books that Google has scanned into their database and that aren't covered by copyright for one reason or another. The usual reason is that it's out of copyright, meaning it's old. You'll notice here we've got 1889, 1842, 1683, 1836, and then we come up here and find a book from 2009. This is probably a government book or a book under Creative Commons. Creative Commons is a sort of copyright that allows you to read the material and use it as long as you're not profiting from it. So those are the kinds of books that you'll be able to read right here online. And you can see all these little highlights here are where the word peace is going to be labeled. And this book is something from the U.S. Marine Corps, so it's probably a report or something of that sort. But still, it's something you can read for free online via the books. The next menu we're going to look at, we're going back to any books. Is the Any Document menu. This is a really great menu to use. You can choose to look at any document, means everything that says books, everything that says peace, or you can look at the books menu, which limits it down to only books, takes out all the magazines and newspapers, or you can limit it to magazines. Magazines is one of the coolest and least known tools, I think, that Google has. It's an archive of hundreds and hundreds of different magazines. Sometimes they're full run. So Life Magazine, Time Magazine, Anthropologica, New Scientist, all of these are. And Ebony. It's got a full run of Ebony. So here's an Ebony from January of 1986. And you're able to look actually at the magazine, and it loads every single page, so you can see the table of contents and the magazine exactly as it was back then, page by page. It is such a cool tool. And then if you've finished with magazines, you can look at newspapers. Same deal with newspapers. They're generally out of copyright. And papers that Google has scanned in. Some of them are really cool. A lot of local papers. So Arizona Journal Miner, the Lewiston Evening Journal from 1944, the Heppner Gazette Times. Lots and lots of little towns had newspapers over the last couple of centuries. So lots of them are really cool to look at. Here's the Philippine Daily Inquirer. Worth a look, but historical. And that is the end of the Any Document list. And then you can look by any time. So you can limit yourself to the 21st century. You can limit yourself to the 20th century. You can limit yourself to the 19th century. Or you can make a custom range. So, for instance, if I wanted to look at books from, say, 1970 through to September 1st, 2001, just to see what books on peace were like in the 30 years prior to 9/11 and the towers going down. So these are books in that time period. You can also look at magazines in this time period, etc. The last option is sorted by relevance or sorted by date. I would always leave it sorted by relevance because their relevance sort includes looking at the date as one of the qualities that they count in determining relevance. So you tend to get both relevance and the other. But if it's really important that you look by for a certain date, this sometimes can help. And that's the end of the video on book search tools. Once again, you can start out at Google, type in your keyword, click on books, either at more or one of those tabs, and then use these tools. Interesting. There looks like there was an old company called COVID. That's funny. So it's not going to have any relevance at all to our COVID, but still interesting. Anyway, enjoy and have fun. That's it for here.